Tell them, recruits. First of all, tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram. It's New York. My fingers are freezing. It's probably like with the wind chill, it's probably 10 degrees right now.
Oh, yeah. Y'all go follow me on Instagram at Tyler McCrary. Twitter, Tyler McCrary, and I'm on Facebook as
spell
well.
Spell your last name. Tyler, everybody knows how to spell.
McCrary.
14-0?
Yes, sir.
What's it like, first of all, to be in camp with Robert Easter Jr.? Obviously, you got a jacket, so you're a big part of the camp. It's not a mistake.
That's my
Those jackets are expensive. They're like $400 or $500.
Man, I mean, when you with the bunny team, you know what I'm saying, and you got about Benz on the side, nothing matter about that, you know?
What's it like? Like, how does he train? What's the vibe like? What's the gym like?
Oh, man, when we in the gym, we going hard. It's especially when it's fight time, you know what I'm saying? But we in the gym always working hard and perfecting our craft.
Have you ever sparred him?
Oh, yeah. I was so crazy. I sparred him before when the buzz was going around when he was getting ready for Mikey Garcia or whatever, or before camp. We got some work in, and we sparred 20 minutes straight. No rest.
What was that like? 20 minutes straight? He hits hard. He's tall. He's lengthy.
I mean,
you're relentless, too. You're 14-0. He's, you know?
He, man, special fighter, great fighter. And I'm not just saying that because that's my bro, but I'm saying, like, He just something different. Punch hard, speed is crazy, and know how to use his reach as well, but he just liked to fight.
He's undefeated, he's a champion.
Uh-huh.
He's popular in Toledo. Are you in Toledo as well?
Oh yeah, yeah.
What are people saying in Toledo about Robert Easter Jr.?
Oh man, they show mad love. As you can see, we was upstairs in the hotel and the whole lobby is Toledo, man. They love Robert down there.
What has been your experience to be around Adrian Broner? Cool guy.
Yeah, but one of the most humblest dudes, really off camera. People don't know.
Oh,
we about to get hit.
It's New York. It's okay. You could jaywalk.
Yeah, people don't know, man. AB really a humble dude, a genuine person. You know.
Okay. He's a humble dude.
Yeah, he real genuine, man.
Very generous. Give
his last to anybody. You know. But it's been a great experience being around him, you know, especially during fight time, seeing him train, you know. And one of the most important things he taught me was be yourself in boxing.
What does that mean, be yourself in boxing? Don't try to be someone you're not.
Yeah, don't try to put on a front.
Don't be a Pacquiao. Don't be a Mayweather. Tyler McCrary.
Yeah, just don't try to put on a front. Be yourself, you know. And what works for you is for you. You know what I'm saying? What he does with his life and for his exposure is working. He's selling out arenas and people come to see him.
He has a million followers on Instagram.
Yeah, they might come to see him lose, but they still come to see him. At the end of the day, they spending that dollar.
What makes you good as a fighter? How did you get 14-0? How many knockouts? 8, 9 knockouts?
No, I got 6 knockouts.
Okay.
But
still a lot.
Yeah. What makes me a great fighter is my mind. You know, like when I'm in the ring, I automatically just know I'm the best. You know, can't nobody beat me when I get in that ring. And I'm so smooth, I'm composed. I'm never under pressure. I might bend a little bit, but I'm never breaking.
Tyler, how many, you're like bamboo, bend but don't break.
Yep.
How many amateur fights have you had?
I had about 95 amateur fights. And
how many wins out of that?
Out of that, I probably won about 75 or something. I never took boxing serious as an amateur, you know. I was just in it because I had the skills to do it, but didn't really train as much and took it as serious.
Not like now. Now it's your life.
Yeah, now I'm committed to it. I do this. I live this.
Who's your favorite fighter of all time?
Of all time? Ali. That's my favorite fighter of all time. Not just because of the boxing, but his lifestyle, you know?
What he stood for, what he represented.
Yes, sir.
By the way, Tyler, they say New York is a city that never sleeps.
Everybody sleeps, supposedly.
I'm sorry. It's 1 o'clock, maybe 2 a.m. I don't know. We left the fight hotel. We're going to another fight hotel right here. Fight weekend. Mm-hmm. Errol Spence is fighting Lamont Peterson. And almost no one on the streets of New York. And it's supposed to be like packed with people 24/7. That's what I was told.
I think we're in the wrong part. Go to Times Square. We'll definitely see a big difference. Oh, and another thing.
Here's someone who just stole something.
Andre Ward, that's one of my favorite fighters.
Very
well.
Smart fighter. Do you fight like him, do you think?
I try to pick up something from a lot of great fighters. I picked up something from Andre Ward.
What did you pick up from Ward? What did you pick up from Mayweather? What did you pick up from Broner?
Mayweather is the defense, you know. Not to get hit. We in this sport for longevity. Broner, that monster, especially 130, 135.
Oh, God.
Four division champion?
Yeah, he was a killer. He still is a killer. But you know what I'm saying? He had bounced back from losses. I'm real sure of that. And Andre Ward, it's a lot I learned about him, you know.
That's dope. A UPS truck that got jacked and they just covered it.
Yeah, you see
graffiti.
The graffiti and shit all over?
Yeah.
That shows that we gotta make a ride
that's
up here
more,
too.
That's more LA style.
Yeah. I ain't never been to LA. I gotta get to LA.
Oh, you gotta come check it out. Well, hopefully you'll fight in LA soon.
Oh yeah. We working on some things, man.
Your next fight, February.
Yeah, they told me February, you know.
Hopefully,
but we just staying busy and staying in shape. My time comes soon. You guys will see more of me real soon.
One more time so people were to follow you.
Tyler McCray _ on Instagram. And the rest of social media is Tyler McCray.
Spell your last name one more time.
McCray. I can't wait until I get to that point in my career when I won't have to do that.
All right. They say work so hard until people don't need to...
ask who you are.
Yep. You heard that one, huh?
Yeah, I heard about that. And that sticks with me.
There you have it. But at this point, I think your name is bigger than your face. And I take it as a compliment. Like, you can hear your name everywhere, but I don't know if you get the exposure, like, name recognition. Like, they may not recognize you, but they know your name.
Yeah, I get that a lot, too. Like,
because in your boxing world, you are known.
Yeah, most definitely. Everywhere I go, somebody knows me. I'm always getting a picture taken or an autograph, especially in Ohio, you know. But
yeah, I was sitting near you last time Adrian Broner had lunch.
Yeah.
It was like for $2,500. But yeah. It was a steakhouse.
Yeah, that was in Cincinnati, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Alright, there you have it, I think. Stay tuned, FreeUsereport.com right here in New York City. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. No joke, it's cold. Does it get this cold in Toledo?
Fuck yeah, it's colder than this in Toledo.
So this is summer for you, huh?
No, it's not summer because it's still freezing, but it's cold right now in Toledo, just like this.